Armageddon News, the Assyrian Antichrist. When the seventh angel blew his trumpet, there were loud voices in heaven, saying, "The kingdom of the world has become the kingdom of our Lord, and of his Christ. The nations were angry, but your wrath has come. It is time for the dead to be judged to reward your servants, the prophets, the saints, and all who fear your name, both unimportant and important, and to destroy those who destroy the earth." Then the temple of God was opened in heaven, and the ark of the covenant of the Lord appeared in his temple. And there were lightnings and voices and thunders, and great hail. A spectacular sign appeared in the sky, a woman dressed with the sun, who had the moon under her feet and a victor's crown of 12 stars on her head. Then another sign appeared in the sky, a huge red dragon. Then a war broke out in heaven. Michael and his angels fought with the dragon, and the dragon and its angels fought back. But it was not strong enough, and there was no longer any place for them in heaven. The huge dragon was thrown down. That ancient serpent, called Devil and Satan, and its angels were thrown down with it. And when the dragon saw that he was cast unto the earth, he persecuted the woman, Israel, which brought forth the man-child, Jesus Christ. And to the woman, Israel, were given two wings of the great eagle, that she might fly into the wilderness, into her place, where she is nourished for a time, and times, and half a time, from the face of the serpent. And the serpent cast out of his mouth water as a flood after the woman, that he might cause her to be carried away of the flood. And the earth held the woman, and the earth opened her mouth, and swallowed up the flood which the dragon cast out of his mouth. This fleeing into the wilderness is consistent with the Antichrist's attack on Jerusalem, and Judea fleeing into the mountains of Petra. While the Antichrist's army like a flood, pursues them, but is swallowed up by the earth. And the dragon was enraged with the woman, and he went off to make war with the rest of her seed, who keep the commandments of God, and have the testimony of Jesus. Revelation 13 describes the rise of the beast union, which has 10 kings, under the authority of the Antichrist. And I saw one of his heads as it were wounded to death, and his deadly wound was healed. This wound which heals either describes an empire like Babylon or Ottoman being restored, or the Antichrist having been fatally wounded and recovering supernaturally. Then he opened his mouth in blasphemy against God, to blaspheme his name, and his dwelling, and those who dwell in heaven. And it was granted to him to make war with the saints and to overcome them. And authority was given him over every tribe, people, language, and nation. The Bible says the Christians will die by being beheaded. Beheading is part of Sharia law. This act tells us that the Antichrist's empire will be Islamic. And then I saw another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and he spoke like a dragon. And he exercises all the authority of the first beast before him, and he causes the earth and those who dwell in it to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed. This second union will be under the authority of the beast union, and will be headed by the false prophet, a religious figure, likely the Pope. This union will have authority over religion and a new monetary system. The Antichrist will sit in the temple of God, proclaiming himself God, and perform miracles deceiving mankind. His false prophet will perform satanic miracles such as calling fire from heaven. The false prophet will also call on the world to set up some form of image to be worshipped. The image itself will speak and demand worship, under the penalty of death. The word for image in Greek is the word icon, a likeness, that is, literally, statue, profile, or, figuratively, representation, or resemblance. This means that, when the false prophet tells the world to make an image of the beast, he may be referring to either a statue or a photograph. The image of the beast as a photograph is more likely, and he will give satanic life to it, enabling it to speak. The false prophet will institute the mark of the beast. Without it, no one will be able to buy or sell. By taking the mark, mankind will sell their souls for food. The Bible says those who take it will suffer eternal fire and damnation in hell. So the first angel went, and poured his bowl on the earth. A horrible, painful sore appeared on the people who had the mark of the beast, and worshipped the image. Then the second angel poured out his bowl into the sea, and it became blood, as of a dead man, and every living thing in the sea died. The third angel poured his bowl into the rivers and the springs of water, and they turned into blood. Then I heard the angel of the water say, "You have given them blood to drink, because they have poured out the blood of saints and prophets. This is what they deserve." The fourth angel poured his bowl on the sun. It was allowed to burn people with fire, and they were burned by the fierce heat. They cursed the name of God, who has the authority over these plagues. They did not repent and give him glory. The fifth angel poured his bowl on the throne of the beast. Its kingdom was plunged into darkness. People gnawed on their tongues in anguish, and cursed the God of heaven, because of their pains and sores. But they did not repent of their deeds. The sixth angel poured his bowl on the great Euphrates River. Its water was dried up, to prepare the way for the kings from the east. And I saw three unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon, and out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet. For they are spirits of demons, working miracles, which go forth to the kings of the earth, and of the whole world, to gather them to the battle of that day, the great day of God Almighty, and he gathered them into a place, called in the Hebrew tongue Armageddon. And the seventh angel poured out his vial into the air. And a great voice came out of the temple of heaven, from the throne, saying, "It is done." And voices and thunders and lightnings occurred. And there was a great earthquake, such as has not been, since men were on the earth, so mighty and so great an earthquake. And the great city came to be into three parts, and the cities of the nations fell. And great Babylon was remembered before God, to give to her the cup of the wine of the anger of his wrath. And every island fled away, and mountains were not found. And a great hail, as the size of a talent, came down out of the heaven on men. And men blasphemed God, because of the plague of the hail, for the plague of it was exceedingly great. Immediately after the tribulation of those days shall the sun be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light, and the stars shall fall from heaven, and the powers of the heavens shall be shaken. And then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn, and they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. The Lord shall roar from on high, and utter his voice from his holy habitation. The earth shall reel to and fro like a drunkard, and shall be removed like a cottage. Behold, he comes with clouds, and every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first, then we which are alive, and remain, shall be caught up together with them in the clouds, to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Then I saw heaven standing open, and there was a white horse. Its rider is named Faithful and True, and in righteousness he judges and wages war. Then I saw the beast, the kings of the earth, and their armies gathered to wage war against the rider on the horse and his army. Out of his mouth came a sharp sword, with which he will defeat the nations. He will rule over them with a rod of iron, and he will trample out the wine in the winepress of the furious anger of the Almighty God. The beast was captured, along with the false prophet, who had performed signs on its behalf. Both of them were thrown alive into the lake of fire, that burns with sulfur. Whoever worships the beast, and its image, and receives a mark on his forehead or his hand, will drink the wine of God's wrath, which has been poured unmixed into the cup of his anger. He will be tortured, with fire and sulfur, in the presence of the holy angels and the Lamb. The smoke from their torture goes up forever and ever. There is no rest day or night for those who worship the beast and its image, or for anyone who receives a mark of its name. The sinner's prayer. Jesus, I confess that I'm a sinner and need a savior. I believe you are the Son of God, that you died on the cross for my sins, and that you were raised from the dead. Jesus, come and be the Lord of my life. If you have said this prayer, find a born-again church that will teach you God's word. For more on the Antichrist, visit 666mark.blog.com.